Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to talk about Power Automate. So what is Power Automate? Basically, it's a way to automate almost anything you do on your computer. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So to get to Power Automate, you just want to go to www.office.com. And once you're on there, you may want to sign in with your Microsoft account. And you can do that by clicking here on the sign in button. And you may have to go through a couple levels of authentication to get on to your Microsoft account. So once you're logged into office.com, you have a couple of options to get to Power Automate. So the best way to do that is to go up here to this button called the App Launcher. And then you may see Power Automate in this list here. If you don't, you can hit All Apps and scroll down, and these are in alphabetical order, and you can find Power Automate here. So you may be asking right now, what is Power Automate? I think a good way to explain that to you is to go down here to the templates and see what's available inside of Power Automate to give you a good feel of what you can do. So let's just see what some of our options are here. You can save any Outlook.com email attachments you get to your OneDrive. You can do the same thing with Gmail and save it to a Dropbox folder. You can send an email for new tweets about a certain keyword, which might be really helpful for your social media managers. You can learn about new rows that have been entered in a SQL database. You can send OneDrive files to an email. You can be notified when a new survey has been submitted. And as you can see, the options here are endless. So these are known as templates. Every one of these icons that you see in here inside of a template is known as a connector. And a connector you can think of as an app. So if I go over here and I click on connectors, I can go up here and I can search for any app that's out there. So let's just take Twitter for now because we're going to use that in our sample today. As soon as I type that in the search box, right here, I can see that Twitter is one of my options for a connector. I can also type in Office, and I can get information about Office 365 users. I can also type in our favorite, Excel, and things can happen based on Excel. So you can see that there's so many apps here that you can perform tasks on. So what I would like to do today in our little demo is I'd like to go up here to Create. And I would like to show you how to create a flow from scratch. So I'm going to scroll up to the top and I'm going to go here to Automated Cloud Flow. And what I would like to do today, since we are a YouTube channel, is I would like to post a tweet automatically every time we put one of our new MyExcelOnline videos on YouTube. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So I'm going to call this flow YouTube to Twitter. Now I want you to look up here and you see this is called a flow name. So I just want you to know that if you've heard flow before, we're really working with the same thing. So now choose my flow's trigger. Down here, I'm going to choose YouTube. And once I put that in, I can see what my YouTube options are. And I'm going to pick when I upload a video. And then I'm going to hit create. And now I need to sign into my YouTube account. So I'm going to click sign in. And I'm going to choose the account I wish to sign in with. And then I'm going to choose my account within YouTube that I'm going to be monitoring. And then I will hit allow. So now the first step of my flow has been created. Now I'm going to go down here to new step. And this time I'm going to type Twitter. And what would I like to do when I upload a new video? I'm going to go down here to this option that says post a tweet. And I'm going to keep the default here to use default shared application. And I'm going to hit sign in. And here I will be prompted to sign in to my Twitter account. And I'm going to hit remember me and then authorize app. and now I have successfully connected to my Twitter account. Now my tweet text is going to say new video. But do you notice when I clicked in here and started typing that this box appeared over here? This is all the information I can get from the video that I just uploaded. So I would like to say new video with a colon, and I'm going to put the video summary title right after that. So whatever the new video summary title is what's going to pop in right here. And then I'm going to click in media, and I'm going to click the video web link. And then I'm going to hit save. And my flow is ready to go. We recommend you test it. I also recommend that you test this because there are several variables going on here. There are issues with your connectivity, the account that you're using. When connecting to Twitter, you only have 2 connections through this, so you just want to be careful how many times you're connecting to Twitter. But if you are running into some issues, you can go over here to data and look at your connections. And this is how you can find your account connections for both of these accounts right here. Hopefully that will help you do some troubleshooting if you do run into some issues. So this flow that I have created, if I would have gone to templates and searched in here, YouTube to Twitter and hit enter, I could have clicked this right here and automatically created the flow that I just took you through. But I wanted to show you how it was actually done on the back end. Now, a couple more types of flows I would like to show you before the end of our video today. If I go over here to create and I scroll up, I just want to show you, you can do an instant cloud flow, which instead of being triggered over here by an event like posting a video on YouTube, you can manually trigger the flow that you create right here. So it's a matter of what makes the flow happen. In this case, it's an event such as action from another application, something online, or something else that a user has input into. In this case, it's you triggering the flow. And keeping that in mind, I also have a third option over here to schedule a cloud flow. So the first one right here allows you to have something else trigger it. This one allows you to have you triggering it when you would like to. And this one allows the clock to trigger your flow. So hopefully that gives you a good introduction to the Office 365 app Power Automate. We will have several more videos on this coming up in the near future. So if you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. As always, thanks again for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.